working on this desktop recording. I'm using a desktop app that came with it. Multimedia. It's RECFFM MPEG. Record FFmpeg, I guess is what it stands for. It's pretty neat. It's different than, you know, I've used DTK to record my desktop a lot. And this is the main screen of it. That's the audio settings. I have them open so I can see. I've got the mic boost all the way up. But you can set where you want it to go. You can change the player. I don't know what that really means. There's no... Oh, there's a play button right there. I hadn't noticed that. Okay, so I guess whatever player you want to use, you can change. It started at AV Play is what it started off with. I guess you could do that while you're recording because it's not in play mode. So it's got those four to choose from. I'm going to leave it there and see what happens after I get done. I'm not going to change anything else while I'm recording. You can minimize it when recording starts, but I decided since it has two little desktops, you can switch quickly. I just left it up. The audio, mine's, it was defaulted to Pulse Audio, but that didn't get you nothing. There's nothing shows up in the window on this laptop. It's a Dell 1525 with 3 gig RAM and 2-core, dual core, 2 gigahertz processor. It's not real fast. I tried adding the webcam. It'll be webcam. Click out there and get the webcam. I tried adding that and it overran the machine. So this is the limit of what it'll do. It's doing somewhere under it shows you it's 25 frames per second. Oh, here it is, 25 frames per second. MPEG 4, MKV format. Really simple to get going. DTK and some of the others really take some work. I have a learning curve to get all going. I mean, it's dependable. GTK is pretty dependable once you get all set up right. You got to figure out what will work with your machine. That's one of the main things, what your machine can handle. You can easily overwhelm your machine with that. It'll do high quality if you set it, you know, if you do the highest quality, any of these machines won't lock out or handle like this desktop. It's even slower than the laptop. It's 1.8 gigahertz and 3 gig RAM. I used to have only 2.5 gig RAM, but I acquired a few more parts recently working on somebody's computer that was messed up. Excuse me. Ended up keeping the old one and building them a new one. So, up here on the desktop, you get when your main icons you get installment to. Persistent Creator, that's pretty cool. You can open that up and I think I've opened that up right now. Yeah. You can open it up and you can set up a persistent storage on your USB stick with Neptune. I guess it means the one, like I can do that with the one I'm using right now. I thought it meant, you know, burn Neptune to another stick and do that with it, but I don't think it's saying you can do that with the one you're using right now. And then no, it's just create an image. Yeah, it's what I thought. So you can create an image with a persistent amount of storage, then you can carry that around and use it in many different machines and not lose your work. You know, but you need a bigger stick than I got. I got a 2 gig stick, and in the Neptune ISO image is 1.8 gigs, so just barely can get it on there. I had to delete a few files. I just had a few files on there, maybe not even 100 megabytes, and I had to delete them to get it on there. So, anyway, quick start guides, and I don't know the DE. I've seen it, you know, before, but that's the, evidently probably the language of the program that made the group. It's a whole group that makes it. Then they have one. Couldn't use it without it, could I? You go into the web browser, it has Chrome and by default. Go straight to their website. Yeah, it has all the flippy floppy effects. This is a KDE 4.14, I think I saw earlier. I didn't like it, then keep using it. It's a lot less heavy on the resources. KDE is pretty, you know, got some good features, but it's also a little heavy on the resources. It gives you the good idea of what's going on with it, and the main apps it's got. That's what convinced me to go try it out. The About section is where I really found out all about it. And that other page I was on told you the version of KDE that it uses, but the Bane's great because it's kind of odd. It's running great. I'm doing a desktop recording. It's not slow. I was going to say it's slow, but it's only the slightest bit slow because I'm doing a desktop recording. And I just figured out in KDE you can do that. You can drag that second to the top bar and drag, and then see, I can't get a hold to my. I had to use the window. I got two monitors. I mean, this is on a laptop, but I have to look to my left to see that. But it's open to my left on my tray. My keyboard tray actually is what it is on my computer rack. I have a rack out of a telecommunications office. I used to be an installer back in 2000, and they were throwing one away one day, and I kept it. It's pretty cool. I got it full of audio gear, and computers. So anyway, my main monitor is what I'm working on here, but I had to use the, where's the settings, okay, area setting, full screen, it actually did the oddest thing, it kind of split the two screens in half, didn't get either one or both of them. Window, of course, every time I changed out of one program to another, I knew what I was doing, so that didn't work. But the area selector, I don't know, it seems to be just cutting off the top, but I'm not sure if it's doing that in the video, if it just looks that way to me. This blue line up here may show up with the red dots, that's where you drag and drag that around to make it fit what area you want to get. Software Center, I'm going to open that up now, it's probably used too many resources. I imagine it uses Synaptic. You can go through the searcher. Depends on what you're, okay, it's using Apper, and there's two of them, Apper, and I don't know, that might be another link to Apper, actually, I don't know. The search is really great, you know, but I have a desktop search on mine too, my Fedora, I have different ones, Fedora 14 I have, something I can't remember, and Fedora 19, which is actually what, I'm running Fedora 19, what's installed on this laptop is Fedora 19. I'm just running this Neptune off of a live USB stick. It's pretty impressive for what all you can do. It all actually works live without any installation and updates. But Office, it's got everything you need to for a fully functional system, and you can edit videos and stuff with multimedia. It's got you can edit audio. There's a player. It's a player. That's a full DAW. Audio editing suite, multi-track suite. Audacity is the one I use all the time. You can just do two channels, but it's pretty powerful. That's what I'm using to record the desktop with. Oops. Back. Audio video converter. I haven't opened it. I keep meaning to. I'm going to open it. Which one it is. Oh, it opened up in my desktop. In my laptop window. There we go. Choose your format. Choose your codec, and then tell it where to go. Oh, open. Choose your file at the very top. I'll skip that. Encode. That's pretty cool. Sweet. Simple. I'm not going to do it right now. Multimedia. And then disk burning. K3B. That's my favorite disk burning app. Kden Live Video Editor. The best Linux video editor I've used. That's one I've used, period, because the others, any that might be better, cost too much for me to use. All the Windows ones I used, they were free and were always full of, you know, they only partially worked, and, you know, they were basically trial or whatever. as they say, non-destructive video editor, and it's pretty darn powerful. Starts out there with, you can add more scenes, or whatever they call them. So, you know, audio tracks, more videos, 3 already and 2 audio tracks. It has its stereo or select in any a lot of instructional in one place right there. I'm not sure if that might be just because I never went there. That might be the guy who executed. I've seen that there's 1 or 2 videos I got off their website, and I got what I needed, and then I haven't actually been back, figured out how to do. But I've been able to figure out Katie Love just by trial and error on most of it. So anyway, you've got your graphics, what's it got in there, drawing, it's got paint, I haven't really ever used that. It's got all your, KDE based programs, but I like a bunch of those programs. Ice-T for your Java, play your Java, so you don't even have to install Java. OpenJDK, policy tool, that'd be for this. I haven't really used that. That's for setting your, I guess, what you let play and what you don't want to play. So I'm thinking that'd be hardware manager. I already showed Office. It's a delivery office, full suite. It's even got a couple things I haven't seen. That it must be add-on apps or something that I haven't seen coming with the suite. I've used OpenOffice for years, and then started using LibreOffice when it came out the last three years, and I kind of just use whichever one's easiest, whatever's already in the distro or what I have on what machine, you know. You really don't notice much difference once you open them up and start using them. TrueCrypt, you can encrypt files with it. It's in utility settings area. I mean, that's one good thing. It's organized well with KDE. The start menu, I guess you could say. Internet. I mean, there's not a whole lot of apps in here, but it's got pretty much what you really need. It's really good, you know, if, like I have so many applications, 3,500 or something on my Fedora 14 system, the one I've been using for years. And I definitely got to use desktop search to find anything, because I have the ones, I use the, you know, 2 setup, but I put the ones I use all the time at the top, and then what's open is at the bottom. But, anyway, if I was to install the same thing on a different regular and see if I could put mate on it, which I know you could, I'm almost positive you can put mate on any domain, BitTorrent client, remote desktop, KRDC, that's a good one, desktop sharing, yeah, I imagine you can set up your desktop sharing with that one, K network monitor, I saw something a while ago, it has wire application. It just has this one thing. Formula editor from LibreOffice. I didn't even know that existed. I think I went in there and the gal was in there a while ago. Jack control. That's a kind of really complex. Jack control is real complex. Audio in and out. I/O in and out application. And it's really cool once you get it working. But if it's not come over and set up for you, I tried to figure it out on and off for years, and I never got it. It's just so much trouble to figure it out. Big learning curve. But if it's already set up, it's great. If you just have to click on it and turn it on, then it's fine. Which I don't know if it is or not. It probably is. They got to where most distros do that now. Kidding line. Sound mixer. Oh, that's the mixer. That's this or something like that. If I just ended up closing it now, that's it. I'm going through it like this because I can show each thing. You'll see, of course, the best video player, audio video player in the world. My favorite, anyway. X-Jack video monitor. Yeah, that's part of Jack. Video, YouTube. You have to put a URL in there. Software management. They'd be using. First thing I'd want is fire. The search and go let's back up. Okay. Bang's bug reporting tool. Why is enough to get me back into the Bang? There's only a few. I used to Bang for 2 years. I was to Bang inch and a half for 2 years. And the only thing that kept me from, kind of got me back to Fedora, the only reason I started out with a Fedora remix called Blag Linux in 2005. I discovered it and had everything, including the kitchen sink. There is an app called Kitchen Sink. I don't know if it's in there, but I've seen it. Anyway, nothing's come up. Oh, by name. With Firefox. Blag was that's what I learned Linux on. I went from started with Blag 5 and up to Blag 9, something went haywire. Well, I think the guy got busy and wasn't able to keep up with supporting it, but it just didn't work. And so I went to Bang. But Bang was always behind on your, on your flash and all that stuff. It wouldn't, back then, anyway, it wouldn't. This is probably about 6 or 7, I don't know. Wouldn't play videos and stuff. And stuff and all that. And you couldn't get installed if you could do it. Fedora 7 then. I that's all I wanted to show. No sense in just installing anything now. Now, which may not be able to get it closed because I've got it up above my. I don't know if you can see that, but it makes my. The way I have this set up to do my desktop recording makes it inaccessible up there. I guess I'm going to have to keep forgetting that I have that problem here while I'm doing this. So, you see, you go search for web and what's already installed here. You got Chromium, you know, different settings, Conqueror, which is not, doesn't have really any, you won't play, you know, stuff. I don't believe it'll play. Well, I tried it earlier. I think it had Flash working, so maybe it will. I just quit using it because it wouldn't play any Java or Flash in any of your normal everyday web pages, and it was real hard. Actually, I don't remember, there was a way to install that stuff back then. You know, I started using Firefox. I already had used Firefox in Windows before 2005. I think I used it in Windows 98, if not in Windows XP. So anyway, yeah, I can't get to any of the close. And this one doesn't have a spot where you can make it smaller, but that's alright. Once I stop my recording over here, I will be able to close it. So, I think this is a pretty cool program in itself here, this desktop recording, recorded FMPEG. Let's see, that's about, I think, time here. Run through the whole thing. So, everything I'm trying to go as quick as I could. Neptune, vein-based distro. It's they did say in their website that they kind of, they have a mix of the vein repositories, the repos and repositories, and anyway, they have their own set up for Neptune. Packages. So, and they also said that they kind of tweaked the kernel up to what where it would do what they want. You know, all the apps work good with all the. Categories, but you'll find thousands of them. That's why I used to search X circuit. That'd be cool. I'll be installing. This is live, so you know, you see me installing anything. But yeah, you know, see, sometimes that can be real quick, and that'd be a good way to do that. Just if you don't really know what you're looking for, you just want to look around. Multimedia, let's see, back to, how would you find, well, I think the best way to find Firefox, since I finally got search working, there we go, there's Adobe Flash plugin already in there, that may be the Firefox that they offer. Some distros don't offer, especially the Bane, straight regular Firefox. I'm sure you could put it on there, but I'm just getting it from the website. But what's in the repos if you said that it would work without any. It's usually, most programs usually work better if you get it straight from the repos. They may be in there and I'm not seeing it. Trying to go fast, which it's a good clean program. Flash plugin non-free. See, that's probably the real one. The real one. The good, that'll be frustrating. But you don't need it if the other one's already on there, it's working. Which it was. I went on my... Did I show that? I've done so many rehashes of this video. Get that back in the middle. I'm probably sorry I did that now. Okay, let's go. No, I don't think I did. Once in a while I record, I'm singing. YouTube, this is a YouTube flash player. So, YouTube Live. Mm-hmm. And I think it worked a long ago. Sometimes these things, this player, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Anyway, period. So let's forget that. Let's go over here to my viewer. That's from 2000. This player here worked a while ago. I don't know if you can hear that. The audio from the website is going straight into the recording or